Every day your cat performs ancient rituals. The silent stalk, the sudden pounce, the long legendary naps. But have you ever stopped to wonder, where did this miniature predator, this purring enigma on your lap, actually come from? It's a journey far older and more surprising than you might imagine, stretching back to a time when cats weren't pets, but architects of their own destiny. Let's uncover their untold story. For a long time, many people thought the story of cat domestication was primarily set in Egypt, which is a pretty fair assumption, isn't it? It's ancient, there's all those amazing hieroglyphs of cats, cat mummies, and the goddess Bastet. And while Egypt definitely played a massive role in celebrating and popularizing cats, the latest science, a brilliant mix of genetics and archaeology, tells us the story starts even earlier, and in a slightly different place. Our cat's domestication journey begins in a region known as the Fertile Crescent. Think parts of modern-day Iraq, Turkey, Syria, and their neighbors. We're talking about 10,000 to 12,000 years ago. This was a revolutionary time for us humans. It's what's called the Neolithic period, where we weren't just hunter-gatherers anymore, we were settling down, becoming farmers, and starting to store our newly domesticated varieties of grain. And here's where the story gets really interesting. This shift in human lifestyle created entirely new opportunities for wild animals. Our world, with its newly stored food, began to intersect with theirs. Some clever wild species saw a golden ticket in our settlements, and one of them would eventually become the ultimate lap lover. But before I reveal how these wild creatures transformed into the cats we know and love today, let's tackle the biggest question. Who were they? Who is the wild ancestor of our beloved house cats? I'm pleased to tell you, genetic detectives have cracked the case. Overwhelming evidence points to one specific wildcat, the African wildcat, or Felis silvestris libica. These guys are remarkably similar to our domestic cats, so much so that even their skeletons can be hard for archaeologists to tell apart. While there are other wildcat subspecies out there, like the European wildcat or the Chinese desert cat, DNA tells us emphatically that our moggies trace their lineage directly back to the African wildcat. So how did these wild hunters become our companions? This is where it gets really interesting, because it seems cats, in typical cat-like fashion, kind of domesticated themselves. It's what scientists call self-domestication. Imagine this, early human settlements are starting to store grain. What does grain attract? Yep, you've got it, rodents. And what loves to hunt rodents? Wildcats. Suddenly, these human villages became an all-you-could-eat buffet for the local African wildcats. And it was a win-win situation. The cats got an easy meal, and humans got some really effective natural pest control. Now, not every wildcat was comfortable with humans. But those who were a bit more tolerant, less easily startled, and just a bit more adventurous, well, they absolutely thrived in these new human settlements. With a steady food supply, these more relaxed cats were healthier and more likely to successfully raise larger litters, naturally passing on those chill genes. Over the generations, this natural selection favored cats comfortable being near people. It wasn't humans actively choosing and breeding them for specific traits, but a unique ecological opportunity that the cats themselves capitalized on. We have some incredible archaeological clues that illustrate this. One of the most amazing is a 9,500-year-old grave found in Cyprus where a human was buried alongside a cat. Now, cats aren't native to Cyprus, which means humans must have intentionally brought them over by boat. This suggests a special bond was already forming, perhaps even beyond just pest control. Then, much later, we see Egyptians embracing cats like no other culture, around 4,000 years ago. They were revered, protected, and became deeply ingrained into the Egyptian art and religion. There's also evidence from other places like China, over 5,000 years ago, of early interactions with cats, but the evidence points to this being an independent event with a different wildcat species, the leopard cat, that didn't lead to the domestic cats we know today. So the Fertile Crescent seems to be where it all kicked off, the ancestral home of every single domestic cat on the planet, from your cozy companion to cats on every continent. But how did these feline globetrotters truly conquer the world, spreading from ancient villages to every corner of the globe? The answer lies with one of humanity's grandest ventures, seafaring. As humans explored and traded across vast oceans, an insidious threat plagued their voyages. Rampant rodent infestations, devouring precious cargo, damaging equipment, and unleashing disease. Sound familiar? Just as they had in early Neolithic villages, a certain feline species answered the call. The domestic cat swiftly became an indispensable member of a ship's crew. This vital maritime partnership transformed them into world travelers, hitching rides with merchants, Roman legions, and European settlers, eventually reaching every corner of the globe. At this point, I'll mention that it's interesting to compare cat domestication to how dogs were domesticated. Dogs were likely domesticated much, much earlier, perhaps 14,000 years ago to 30,000 years ago. And with dogs, humans played a more active role, selectively breeding them for specific tasks like hunting or herding. That's why we see such a huge variety in dog breeds today. Cats, on the other hand, because of the self-domestication route, have changed relatively little from their wild ancestors, both in their looks and their behavior. They've kept a lot of that wild independence, which, let's be honest, is part of their charm, isn't it? The intense selective breeding for different cat breeds is a much more recent thing, mostly in the last 150 years or so. So, your purring companion has a wild heart, with roots stretching back around 10,000 years ago to the African wildcat in the Fertile Crescent. They cleverly moved in with us when we started farming, offering pest control in exchange for a reliable food source. They then traveled the world with us, becoming the most popular pet on the planet. Understanding where our cats come from helps us appreciate their natural instincts and behaviors even more. It explains why they still love to hunt, even if it's just a feather wand, why they value their territory, and why they sometimes seem so wonderfully independent. I've got one final thing for you. If you found this video interesting and want to learn more about cat behavior and how to build an amazing bond with your feline friend, you might like this video. And remember, if you haven't already, hit like and subscribe so you don't miss our next adventure into the world of cats. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.